had a bit of success with that. On the 158 on Wednesday night, at the end of it, one of the guys asked me whether it was me on 70 centimetres on lower sideband, and I said yes and explained a story about what we were doing, and he and his mates hadn't realised that there was an input on a satellite just on 432-150. So I asked him to QSY maybe 20k up the band or something like that, which he was happy to do. So we shouldn't have that sort of a problem in the future, cross fingers. Okay, on the 961, very good. I should have a good chance of working it, so I'll look forward to that, but I'm never very hopeful when someone says they're going to use an egg feeder antenna, and they're not quite as good as a set of Yagi's VK3ZAZ, VK3MQ.
Yeah, no breakers, 3MQ, 3ZAZ. God, thanks for doing that. No fact that you could hear them. Yeah, there's one, a lot of VK3s, but out of range of here. And there's some VK2, so I just put it onto the thing. I did it flippantly, so I'm going to get the better brakes. So this guy's there on, probably went alone when it first got put on. Remember, we had 420 to 430, so we were down the bottom of the band for a CW and EME. And they put the Oscar 7 and Oscar 6 up the top, away from half. But now they're in the middle of the bloody the weekend, what they call it, the field day call frequency. So how many times has it been relayed? That's probably how somebody worked up and was on the air. Now, it's mad, just been running around on other frequencies trying to get decodes on things and working out how to make it work. So thanks for the input on that. The K3 and 3ZAZ.
It's a very long lead satellite, and operating techniques have changed quite a bit since those early days. It's a bit of a problem with the terrestrial stations because they're up and running a fair bit a week. There's a good chance that this thing will shake and rock around and mode switch. So it was a good thing that they're aware of it now. In fact, one of the parts I was listening to the other day, it was pretty close to mode shifting. Whether it crackles or coming in at your end, or whether it's just something lovely for me. But yeah, it's different. Okay, on the closed band 3D as well. And I think Jeff today did was doing a bit of that the other day as well, with some of his pictures from pictures of those things are pointing at the earth. I wonder if there was someone else on the satellite, and that was robbing the power. VK2ZAZ, VK3MQ.
Yeah, it's stopped now. That went right down. I was watching it. It was actually the noise floor drop. I'm not running the 9700, so I don't know. I got this very nice 9904ZQ. With OCX, as you can see, I don't have touch it, it just runs, so the other old 910 has been decommissioned, stuck it on repeaters. Well, I stuck it on 145.825, so that's something interesting. And Merv Hurley and me and VK5ATN and 6HAM were all packing each other over the space station during the night. The wife got upset saying, "Oh, FM radio on 107.9 is making funny noises," so I've actually had to turn the us beaconing every 60 seconds. I got called out to the TV side last night. I was listening to myself going up and down the highway. And unfortunately, low satellite antennas, even with 50 watts, wiped out TV sets. That was my worry about going to live in Ballarat. So there it goes again. Thanks for killing the satellite at the moment, over.
Yeah, I don't know what it is, but it's really making a mess of things. Okay, on the cross radio, they're not much in the way of the receiver, are they? I sympathise anyway, there's a similar situation here with 6 back again. There's all sorts of things you can do in amateur radio and have a lot of fun in the process, so that's all good. Okay, on Roy's 910, well, you should have got a bargain there because Roy really looks after his rig. And from the photographs I saw of it, it looked as though it was pretty, almost brand new. VK3ZAZ, VK3MQ.
What was killing the thing? I heard a radio station up the band last week, and I heard some FM down the band, so maybe it's Indonesia stuff. Totally captures it, doesn't it? It really, you really hear it.
1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 1, 2.
The Indonesian FM stations on this one. Of course, it's a different matter on FO29 and RS44. Let's just keep the uplink clarity on back again. Other satellites, there's a lot more activity in the 2 meter band, illegal activity as well. That really floods it, but first time I've heard a report of this satellite being affected, but anything's possible. VK3ZAZ, VK3MQ.
Go ahead, Roland. Go ahead, mate.
Yeah, Roger there. Good afternoon, guys. I've been listening. I tried to call you before, but I didn't hear myself. I was a bit off, so I corrected that early. Anyway, Vika's really like me back. Well, I had a good copy there on you. Right up to 5 and 9 was gauge. How do you copy, Rob?
Yeah, not too bad, Roland. Satellite's hitting about 7 on my signals at the moment, and you're running about strength 5, so pretty good signal. You're a long way away, so you're doing very well indeed. VK4FB, VK3MQ.
Yeah, what are you doing, VK3MQ? VK4FB, Foxtrot Bravo. Thanks for the 5 and 5. I think you've got a wide view up in the tower. Oh, how's that? Yeah, you're also 5 and 5, a different 5 and 5, but you're as clear as, a bell. And if I look at the meter, it's only a 5, but it comes through very clear, over.
Oh, well, thanks for that, Roland. That's very good. I wonder if you're wearing headphones. It's got that characteristic IC9700 feedback behind you, over.
Yeah, Roger, I'm not wearing headphones. I'm recording. So, sorry about that. That's the sound. And sometimes it's worse than other days, whatever. I'm still running the power now. Down to, what is it? Even worse. Anyway, over to you, Steve, VK3ZAZ, VK4FB, over.
Yeah, VK4FB,
3ZAZ,
I'm down at 2 watts, probably about 20 watts DRP. My feature is that, particularly when I was a kid doing my engineering 50 years ago, this bloody thing was up there and I was working through it using a, 432, I used a corrective transmitter, I got a 13 string MPJ, and I could either transmit down an FM or CW. I'm going to go to the next one.
well. But yeah, Oscar 8 was my first active satellite, and my best VX was from Kilo 8, and he was trying to tell me his name, and I was trying to tell him my name, and it wasn't until I got the QSL card that I realised we both had the same name. But he was saying, oh, yeah, and I was saying, Robert, VK, the 4FB, VK3MQ.
Oh, Richard, yeah. yeah, that's how it is sometimes. So, yeah, still good company on you there. Who else is on there? Did you say VK2ZAZ? And VK3ZAZ? Is that Roger?
No, just me.
It's only you. No, no, Steve. Pretty good. Yeah, it's amazing. There's a lot of shh behind it today. So it's not because I'm not wearing headphones, because I never wear headphones. But anyway, put it over to you, Steve, because we said I said VK4FB.
Using Fortran punch cards to get the kips, and then we'd go up the antenna lab and Stolly rotator and some Channel 5 AOS tenor antennas on 2 meters, and the other ones you could buy for Channel 5 A or 2 meter Yagi's 10 elements crossed, and a homebrew 432 thing, long time ago. Don't have any photos of it that long ago, 1974. In Ballarat College, and I'm thinking of going to build a house just in there now. It's bizarre if I go back and live there. 3MQ in the group. And what am I? I'm still 23 degrees, the K3ZAZ.
Station is Echo 21, Echo Juliet Charlie. What's his name again? I'll catch you next time, Steve. Send this one. Still got that one, VK3MQ. Bottom up, 73. Yeah, the VK4 Foxtrot Bravo. What's your call sign again? You're 5 and 5. Victor Kilo 5, come again. Okay, VK5 Lima Oscar, yeah, still about 5 and 5. Can you give me a report, please? And your name was Park. Name this way is Roland. Roger? Okay, I think we are losing it soon. So, anyway. I gave it a little bit more power, but yeah, it's not working all too good. But can't complain about VK5 Lima Oscar, VK Kilo 4 Foxtrot Bravo, and Alpha Oscar 7. Thank you very much for the contact, 73. Bye bye.